Hi amigos. Here in this video, we can discuss about vertical farming. We all have seen many types of farmlands and plantations, but vertical farming is one of a kind which is comparatively a new technique of growing crops. Here we can find out how vertical farming works, the advantages and disadvantages of this technique, what kind of crops can be grown on vertical farms. Before moving forward, please subscribe to this channel to find interesting videos related to sustainability, energy and nature. By 2050, the world's population is expected to grow by another 2 billion people, and feeding it will be a huge challenge. Due to industrial development and urbanization, we are losing arable lands every day. Scientists say that the Earth has lost a third of its arable lands over the last 40 years. Urban vertical farming is one of the fastest growing trends in food production. One study found that the market for plant factories, what vertical farms are known as in Asia, was about $403 million in 2013 and had the potential to reach $1.97 billion by 2020. Though this includes sales of materials like LED lights and hydroponic pieces, it still speaks to the insatiable growth of the industry. Vertical farming is the practice of growing produce in vertically stacked layers. Vertical farms attempt to produce food in challenging environments, like where arable land is rare or unavailable. The method helps mountainside towns, deserts, and cities grow different types of fruits and vegetables by using skyscraper-like designs and precision agriculture methods. Vertical farms come in different shapes and sizes, from simple two-level or wall-mounted systems to large warehouses several stories tall. But all vertical farms use one of three soil-free systems for providing nutrients to plants, which are hydroponic, aeroponic, or aquaponic. 1. Hydroponics, the predominant growing system used in vertical farms. Hydroponics involves growing plants in nutrient solutions that are free of soil. The plant roots are submerged in the nutrient solution, which is frequently monitored and circulated to ensure that the correct chemical composition is maintained. 2. Aeroponics, NASA is responsible for developing this innovative indoor growing technique. In the 1990s, NASA was interested in finding efficient ways to grow plants in space and coined the term aeroponics, defined as growing plants in an air or mist environment with no soil and very little water. Aeroponics systems are still an anomaly in the vertical farming world, but they are attracting significant interest. An aeroponic system is by far the most efficient plant growing system for vertical farms, using up to 95% less water than even the most efficient hydroponic systems. Plants grown in these aeroponic systems have also been shown to uptake more minerals and vitamins, making the plants healthier and potentially more nutritious. 3. Aquaponics, an aquaponic system takes the hydroponic system one step further, combining plants and fish in the same ecosystem. Fish are grown in indoor ponds, producing nutrient-rich waste that is used as a feed source for the plants in the vertical farm. The plants, in turn, filter and purify the wastewater, which is recycled to the fish ponds. There are four critical areas in understanding how vertical farming works. 1. Physical layout, 2. Lighting, 3. Growing medium, and 4. Sustainability features. Firstly, the primary goal of vertical farming is producing more foods per square meter. To accomplish this goal, crops are cultivated in stacked layers in a tower-like structure. Secondly, a perfect combination of natural and artificial lights is used to maintain the perfect light level in the room. Technologies such as rotating beds are used to improve lighting efficiency. Thirdly, instead of soil, aeroponic, aquaponic or hydroponic growing mediums are used. Peat moss or coconut husks and similar non-soil mediums are very common in vertical farming. Finally, the vertical farming method uses various sustainability features to offset the energy cost of farming. In fact, vertical farming uses 95% less water. Having greater output from a small cultivation area is not the only advantage of vertical farming. Following are some of the major benefits of vertical farming. Preparation for future, By 2050, around 80% of the world population is expected to live in urban areas, and the growing population will lead to an increased demand for food. The efficient use of vertical farming may perhaps play a significant role in preparing for such a challenge. Increased and year-round crop production, vertical farming allows us to produce more crops from the same square footage of growing area. In fact, 1 acre of an indoor area offers equivalent production to at least 4 to 6 acres of outdoor capacity. According to an independent estimate, a 30-story building with a basal area of 5 acres can potentially produce an equivalent of 2,400 acres of conventional horizontal farming. Additionally, year-round crop production is possible in a controlled indoor environment which is completely controlled by vertical farming technologies. Less use of water in cultivation, vertical farming allows us to produce crops with 70 to 95% less water than required for normal cultivation. Not affected by unfavorable weather conditions, crops in a field can be adversely affected by natural calamities such as torrential rains, cyclones, flooding or severe droughts, events which are becoming increasingly common as a result of global warming. Indoor vertical farms are less likely to feel the brunt of the unfavorable weather, providing greater certainty of harvest output throughout the year. Increased production of organic crops. As crops are produced in a well-controlled indoor environment without the use of chemical pesticides, vertical farming allows us to grow pesticide-free and organic crops. Human and environmentally friendly, indoor vertical farming can significantly lessen the occupational hazards associated with traditional farming. Farmers are not exposed to hazards related to heavy farming equipment, diseases like malaria, poisonous chemicals, and so on. As it does not disturb animals and trees inland areas, it is good for biodiversity as well. Vertical farming has a lot of promise and sounds like the farm of the future. However, there are a few stumbling blocks to consider before rushing full speed ahead into vertical farming. No established economics, the financial feasibility of this new farming method remains uncertain. The cost of building skyscrapers for farming, combined with other costs such as lighting, heating, and labor, can easily outweigh the benefits we can get from the output of vertical farming. For a 60-hectare vertical farm, the building cost can be well over $100 million. And while vertical farms will be attractive to locate close to cities, the high price of real estate will impede the financial viability of urban locations. The financial situation is changing. Difficulties with pollination. Vertical farming takes place in a controlled environment without the presence of insects. As such, the pollination process needs to be done manually, which will be labor-intensive and costly. Labor costs, as high as energy costs are in vertical farming, labor costs can be even higher due to their concentration in urban centers where wages are higher, as well as the need for more skilled labor. Automation in vertical farms, however, may lead to the need for fewer workers. Manual pollination may become one of the more labor-intensive functions in vertical farms. Too much dependency on technology, the development of better technologies can always increase efficiency and lessen costs. But the entire vertical farming is extremely dependent on various technologies for lighting, maintaining temperature, and humidity. Losing power for just a single day can prove very costly for a vertical farm. So after considering these pros and cons, what kind of crops can be grown on vertical farms? One of the biggest decisions that can make or break a vertical farm is the question of which crops to grow. Along with a number of other key factors including a good location and an appropriate pricing strategy, smart crop choices play an essential role in helping vertical farms keep costs down and ensuring that farmers are able to sell the majority of what they grow. Lettuce, kale, chard, and collard greens, basil, chives, and mint are the most profitable ones. Some farmers successfully cultivated tomato, strawberry, and some other crops like that. This industry is still young, are trying to work out the right business models and direction. The entrepreneurs don't agree on everything, though they certainly agree on this: vertical farming has the potential to transform global food production as we know it.